Are we going?
Yeah.
Okay. Binomial theorem. Sometimes there comes a need to raise a binomial to a big exponent. The first thing you got to remember, though, on x plus 4 squared, biggest no-no in algebra, which you will, of course, not do, is to tell me this is just x squared and 4 squared, or x squared plus 16. Huge no-no, because you know that you don't distribute the power if you have terms inside the parentheses, only if you have factors. If you have terms, you got to treat this like when you square something, you multiply it times itself, so you get x squared plus 4x, and 4x again, 8x in the middle, last times last, plus 16. You remember that. But we're going to look at generic binomials for a minute. A plus B. If we square it, we have to think A plus B times A plus B. A squared plus AB. Then when you distribute, don't call it AB one time and BA another time, because you might not recognize that they're like terms. If you'll name your variables alphabetically, then we recognize that's another AB. Last times last plus B squared. So A squared plus 2AB plus B squared. Not just A squared plus B squared. That's the no-no. So if we want to do A plus B cubed, here's what it's not. It is not just A cubed plus B cubed. That's the no-no. Avoid that. You have to think of it as A plus B times A plus B times A plus B again. Here's the good news, though. We've already done A plus B times itself. We know the answer. So I'm going to put this answer right here. A squared plus 2AB plus B squared gets multiplied by another A plus B. I always think it's easiest to distribute from the small to the big. You can distribute from the big to the small, it doesn't matter. But here we go, y'all help me out. So we have A cubed and 2A squared B, and then AB squared. Distribute the B, so we have another A squared B. Line up things that are alike, and 2AB squared, and finally, B cubed. So the A cubed and the B cubed do really show up as part of the answer, but we got to remember there are middle terms along with those two. So A cubed plus 3A squared B and 3AB squared plus B cubed. So one more time. We're going to do A plus B to the fourth, just because it'll be fun. That means it is not A to the fourth plus B to the fourth. No, no. Instead, you have to think A plus B times A plus B times A plus B times A plus B again. But we already have the answer to A plus B times itself three times, so we're going to start with this. We'll have A cubed plus 3A squared B plus 3AB squared plus B cubed times A plus B one more time. So here we go. We do get A to the fourth, but we also get middle terms. We'll get 3A cubed B and 3A squared B squared and AB cubed. And then we got to distribute the B. So we have A cubed B. I'll line it up where it's alike. And 3A squared B squared. And 3AB cubed. And finally, B to the fourth does show up as the last term. And so when we combine things that are alike, here's where we land. A to the fourth plus 4. Are you up for doing A plus B to the 10th? Keep going, doing this 10 times? Okay. Well, the need to do that came up, and this mathematician named Pascal said, there has to be an easier way. So he started looking for patterns. And the first thing he did was he studied coefficients. So back up with me for a second and add these on to your notes. A plus B to the first and A plus B to the zero. What happens if you do A plus B to the zero?
One.
Anything to the zero power is one. And A plus B to the first, we would just have A plus B. So we're going to only look, we're going to do what Pascal did. We're going to only look at coefficients. And we're going to kind of make a list of what is our power, our exponent, and what are the coefficients. And you don't have to write this down because you're going to see it on your notes in a minute. What are the coefficients that go with it? Well, when we did the zero power over here, A plus B to the zero power, the only thing we got was 1. When we did A plus B to the first power, what are our coefficients? 1 and 1. So to the first power, coefficients are 1 and 1. When we did A plus B squared, our coefficients were 1, 2, 1. When we do A plus B cubed, our coefficients are 1, 3, 3, 1. When we did to the fourth power, our coefficients were 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. And what Pascal did has kind of become famous. This study that he did over here is called Pascal's Triangle. Have you ever seen it before? You haven't? It's famous. Could you tell me, without working it out, do you see the pattern that he figured out? Could you tell me what coefficients would we get if we raised a binomial to the fifth power? We would get a 1, and then a 5, 10, 10 again, 5, you got it figured out now? If we raise a binomial to the 6th power, the outside's always going to be a 1. Look up here, I'll show you the secret. 1 plus 1 is where we got the 2. 1 plus 2 gave us the 3. 2 plus 1 gave us the 3. And we have a 1 on the outside. So we have a 1 on the outside. 1 plus 3 gave us 4. 3 plus 3 gave us 6. 3 plus 1 gave us 4. 4 plus 1 gave us 5. And then 3 plus 1 gave us 4. I got ahead of myself. So you see where this one came from? Now see if you can do it. If we multiplied out a binomial and raised it to the 6th power, the coefficients we'd get would be 1. 6,
15,
20,
15,
6, 4. Y'all are so smart. Why didn't you think of that instead of Mr. Pascal, and then you should be famous? So, here's the deal. If you want to raise something to a power, then those are your coefficients. But he had to do more than just figure out what the coefficients were. He also noticed another pattern. Look at what's going on when we squared it. Our first, the A part, started with an exponent of 2, then the next term was down to an exponent of 1, and then A to the 0 could be written here, because that's just 1. And when we were raising something to the 3rd power, look what happened to the A term. A to the 3rd, then A to the 2nd, then A to the 1st, then A to the 0. When we raise something to the 4th term, look what happened to the A part. A to the 4th, A to the 3rd. A to the 2nd, A to the 1st, A to the 0. So he said, okay, the first term of the binomial starts with whatever power we're raising it to. That'll be the biggest exponent, and it goes down in descending order from there. What about the B part? What's going on with it? It's not decreasing, it's increasing, right? So B to the 0, B to the 1st, B to the 2nd. B to the 0, B to the 1st, B to the 2nd, B to the 3rd. So whatever power you're raising it to, that's where you end on the B term. Does that make sense? So B to the 0 to the 1st, B to the 2nd, B to the 3rd, B to the 4th. So the A term is start big and decrease. The B part starts small and increases. So you see the pattern. We're going to practice it in a second. But there's one more thing we've got to learn first. There is another way, because sometimes if you wanted to raise something to the 10th power, you might not want to have to write out Pascal's triangle until you get to the 10th power. So there's another option that you can use for finding these coefficients. And if you look on your notes, it says, the first bullet says, the purpose of the binomial theorem is to come up with a shortcut for raising any binomial to any kind of an exponent. And then the next part says, learn the definition of a binomial coefficient. So do you see this notation on your notes where it says NR? And then you see three bars. And when you see three bars, that means it is defined to be, we talked about factorial when we talked about E, that crazy irrational number, 2.718, blah, blah, blah. This is defined as N factorial divided by R factorial times N minus R factorial. Let me show you what that means. And yes, you can do it on your calculator, but I'm not going to show you yet because I want you to be able to do this by hand. And so when you see 9, 5, it means 9 factorial divided by 5 factorial times 9 minus 5 factorial. 9 or that's really going to be 9 factorial divided by 5 factorial times 4 factorial. If you remember, 9 factorial doesn't mean get really excited about 9. It means do 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Divided by 5 factorial is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And 4 factorial is 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So here's what happens. 4 over 4, 3 over 3, 2 over 2, 1 over 1. Those go away. We also have a 5 on top and a 5 on bottom that would cancel out. And if we think about 3 times 2, that's 6. So 6 would cancel with 6. We could cancel the 8 and the 4, but we'll do that in a minute. So here's what we have left. 9 times 8 times 7 divided by 4. Punch it into your calculator. What do you get? Do another one. If we did the binomial coefficient 8, 3, here's what it means. It means do 8 factorial divided by 3 factorial times 8 minus 3 or 5 factorial. So that would mean do 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. All over 3 times 2 times 1 times 5 factorial, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So you see what happens on this one. 5 over 5, 4 over 4, 3 over 3, 2 over 2, 1 over 1. And again, 3 times 2 is 6, so that'll cancel with this 6. So you don't even have to have a calculator for this one. What do you get? 56. What about that last one on your notes, example 3? Do the binomial coefficient 5, 0. That would mean do 5 factorial divided by 0 factorial, which means you got to remember something. Back when we talked about E, we said 0 factorial is 1. It has to be defined as 1. Otherwise, everything will fall apart. 5 minus 0, we made it undefined, nothing would work. 0 factorial is 1, and 1 factorial is 1. So on this one, oops, I messed up. 5 factorial divided by 0 factorial times 5 minus 0, 5 factorial. So what's going to happen on top? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, over 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, times 1. Where do we land?
Just 1.
Okay, now, if we had done this in a better order, we would have known that the binomial coefficient is kind of a way of counting things. And what it really is, what it really means is, if you see 4-1, this notation is really saying how many different combinations would there be if you have four objects and you're only going to pick one of them. How many different ways could you do that? Like, imagine on this table right here, there's four books. Book A, B, C, D. How many different ways could you just pick one of the books?
Four
different choices, right? So if you were counting the number of ways you could choose from four objects and only pick one of them, there would be four ways to do it. If you...
There's the one on the bottom, isn't it?
But what's the understood one on the top? If you do 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 over 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, and you have an extra 1, what is this really? This is 1 times 1 times 1 times 1 times 1. And if the 1's on the bottom, what is that? That's really just another 1. If we calculated this one a long way, it would be 4 factorial over 1 factorial times 4 minus 1, 3 factorial. Do you see it? What's going to happen? 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 over just 1 times 3 times 2 times 1. Where do we land? 4 over 1.
Yeah.
So we just get 4. If you see this notation, 4-2. What it really means is how many different combinations could you have if you choose from four objects and you pick up two at a time. So here's book A, B, C, D. Help me count these. I could pick up A and B, A and C, A and D. How many is that?
Four.
That's 3. Then I could pick up B and C, B and D. How many is that? That's 5. Or C and D. How many different ways could I pick two books?
6.
Okay. Well, that's what this does for you. 4 factorial divided by 2 factorial times 4 minus 2, 2 factorial. That gives you 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 divided by 2 times 1 times 2 times 1. What happens? 2's canceled, 1's canceled, and we have 12 divided by 2, 6 ways to do it. So this counts for you. How many ways can you choose from 4 objects and pick 2 of them at a time? Okay. But it's a funny coincidence that this counting theory idea also corresponds to what happens with Pascal's triangle. So if you want another way to come up with these numbers right here, instead of having to draw out the triangle and figure out where they are in the pattern, you will get those same numbers if you calculate these coefficients, 4, 0, 4, 1, 4, 2, 4, 3, all the way up to 4, 4. Let's think about this. If you have 4 objects and you pick none of them, how many ways are there to do that?
1.
If you have 4 books and you only pick up book A or book B or book C or book D, how many ways could you choose one object out of 4 things? There would be 4 ways to do it. We did 4-2 just a minute ago. We just counted them. A and B, A and C, A and D, B and C, B and D, C and D. There were 6 ways to do that, right? If you have 4 objects and you choose only 2 of them. Well, it turns out if we calculate 4, 3, guess what we're going to get? 4. And if you have 4 books to pick from and you decide I'm going to choose all 4 of them, there's only one way to do that, right? So it's a funny coincidence that these binomial coefficients give you the same numbers that Pascal's triangle gives you. So down at the bottom of your notes page, the binomial theorem, and I'm not going to make you write this out, But it says if you want to raise any binomial to a power, the way you're going to get the coefficients is you're going to start with n0, and your next coefficient will be n1, and you're going to keep going until you hit nn. And you're going to start with the a part raised to the n power, and the b part raised to the 0. And the next one, the n's are going to go down, so the a part will be n minus 1, and the b part is going to be 1. And you're going to keep going until your last term, you'll have, what's the a part going to be on the last term? A to the 0, and the b part is going to be to the n. Okay? So that's what the binomial theorem says. So turn over on the next page on your notes, and let's do an example. So let's do x plus 7 to the 5th. When you have to raise something to the 5th power, the first thing you have to find are the coefficients. If we cheat and we look at Pascal's triangle, to the 5th power, our coefficients are going to be 1, 5, 10, 10, 5, 1. But if we didn't have Pascal's triangle in front of us, and we needed to figure it out a different way, then the first term would have the coefficient that starts with 5, 0, and some variables. And the next term would start with 5, 1, and some variables. And then the next coefficient would be 5, 2, and then 5, 3, and then 5, 4, and then 5, 5. And then we got to realize that we have coefficients and variables. What's the a part going to start with? X to the 5th. X to the 5th. And then there will be a b part. And then the next one will be x to the, oops, x to the 5th. And then x to the 4th. And then x to the 3rd. And x to the 2nd. And x to the 1st. And x to the 0. And the b part starts with 7 to the 0. Now, it's coefficient times variable plus next term. Coefficient times, what's the b part going to be this time? 7 to the 1st. Plus coefficient times variable times, what's the b part this time? 7 squared. Plus coefficient times variable times, this time, what's the b part? 7. The b part increases, so it'll be 7 to the 3rd. And then coefficient times variable times 7 to the 4th. And when you get to the last term, the a part is to the 0, and the b part is to the 5th, because we're raising it to the 5th. Here's another little trick. If you think, ooh, I've gotten off somewhere, here's how you can check it. All of the exponents, 5 plus 0, adds to be 5. 4 plus 1, adds to be 5. 3 plus 2, 2 plus 3, 1 plus 4, 0 plus 5. Every term has exponents that add to be whatever power you're raising it to. So now, let's simplify. If you have 5 things to pick from, and you choose none of them, how many ways can you do that? We know if we calculated this, we would get a 1. If you have 5 objects to choose from, and you only pick one of them, how many ways could you do that? Yeah. And so we know that to the 5th power, y'all know how to evaluate. We did it earlier. But for sake of time, these numbers, 5, 2 is going to turn into 10. 1, 5, 10, 10. Oops, I missed one. 1, 5, 10, 10. No, I didn't. 5, 1. Now, the coefficients are there, but when we simplify, sometimes the coefficients are hiding. So here's what happens when we simplify. We have 1 times x to the 5th times 7 to the 0 That's one. So the first term does just turn out to be, in this case, x to the fifth. The next term is y times x to the fourth times 7. So after we simplify, that 5 is going to be hiding inside of 35 x to the fourth. And when we simplify the next term, we'll have this coefficient, if we calculated it, it's 10 times x to the third times 7 squared, that's 49. So the 10 is there, but it's going to be hiding inside of 490 x to the third. And the next term is 10 times x squared times 7 to the third is 343. So the 10's there, but when we multiply and simplify, the 10 is now hiding inside of 3,430 x squared. And our next term is 5 times x times 7 to the fourth. Anybody have that one?
2,400.
So the 5 is there, but when we simplify, 5 times 2,401, we get 12,005 times x. And our last term, we have a 1 times x to the 0, which is also 1. And 7 to the 5th power is 16,807. So here's the deal. If you were to multiply x plus 7 times itself 5 times, this is where you would land if you didn't make any mistakes. And this is a little bit tedious at first until you get used to it, but that's still a whole lot easier than multiplying x plus 7 times x plus 7, get an answer, times x plus 7 again times an answer, right? You agree? Let's do one more. Look at number 2 on your notes. Tell me what you notice that's different about that one. There is a 2x. There's a 2 in front of the x. That will make a difference. And what else? A minus. You got it. If there is a minus, you better tell yourself, okay, the potential for messing up on signs is real. Be careful. Yes.
I might have missed you if you said it or something, but like when it was 5 over 2, how do you just know that it's 10?
Because we learned. Here, how do you do 5 over 2? You do 5 factorial, because I gave you the rule for it. It's 5 factorial divided by 2 factorial times 5 minus 2, 3 factorial. I just for sake of hurrying, I didn't go through this again, but it would be 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 divided by 2 times 1 times 3 times 2 times 1. So if you go through the process.
Okay, so you would go through the process.
Yes. Actually, I'm going to show you how to do it.
Oh, next time.
I
was like, just know that?
But no, I showed you how to do it. I just, for sake of time, didn't go back through it. But I am going to show you how to do it on your calculator. Just not today, because I want y'all to have fun with it first. And for sake of time, because it takes a minute. 2x minus 3 to the 4th power. We want to know what would we get if we did 2x minus 3 times 2x minus 3 times 2x minus 3 times 2x minus 3 again. Well, we don't really want to have to multiply that all out. So we're going to use the binomial theorem to help us. If we cheat and we refer back to the front where we have Pascal's triangle, this is to the 0, to the 1st, to the 2nd, to the 3rd, to the 4th. So what are our coefficients going to be? 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. So we're going to pretend for a minute that we don't know that. And so if we're going to expand this out, we know that we'll have a coefficient that comes from 4, 0. Do you know what that one is automatically?
1.
Yeah, that one's a 1. Then we'll have another coefficient that is 4, 1. Do you know what that one is?
4.
That one's 4. We'll have a coefficient that is 4, 2. You may not know that one off the top of your head, but if you don't, you can do 4 factorial divided by 2 factorial times 4 minus 2, 2 factorial, okay? But for sake of time, we're not going to calculate it at this moment. We're gonna cheat and know that it's 6 because Pascal's triangle tells us that it is. And then we'll do 4, 3, and finally 4, 4. on this one, you're going four objects to pick from. Pick all four of them. How many ways can I do that? Only one. And this one is going to turn out to be four. So we know what our coefficients are, 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. What about the variables? Here's where you have to be careful. The A part, this time, is not just an X. Instead, it's 2X. So we start big, 2X to the 4. And the B, what's the B part? Well, okay, it'll be to the 0 power, but the B value in this case, the sign, negative 3. So we'll have negative 3 to the 0. Check it. Exponents add to be 4. Plus, next term, coefficient times, what's my A part? 2X will be raised to the 3rd, and the B part, negative 3, is raised to what? To the 1st. Plus, next term, coefficient times 2x, this time is squared, and negative 3 is squared. Notice, it's coefficient times variable, plus next term, coefficient times variable. This time, we started with 2x to the 4th, 2x to the 3rd, 2x to the 2nd, 2x to the 1st, and negative 3, if I forget where I am, I know 1 and something has to add to be. Had to be 4, the exponent. So this has to be to the 3rd. Plus, last term, I end up with the A part being to the 0 power, and the B part is now to the 4th power. So simplify. Where do we land? We know this coefficient is 1. Be careful. What happens with 2x to the 4th? You know that this means 2x times 2x times 2x times 2x. It's not just 2 to the 4th. What is it? It's 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. It's 16x to the 4th. And negative 3 to the 0 is 1. So that term just turns out to be 16x to the 4th. Next term. I have 4. What if we do 2x to the 3rd? That means 2x times 2x times 2x. So that turns into 8x cubed. People mess up right here because they'll just go, oh, it's just 2 with an x to the 3rd. It's not. 2 gets the 3rd and x gets the 3rd because those are factors inside the parentheses. We distribute the power to both. Or think of it like this. 2 times 2 is 4 times 2 is 8. 8x cubed times, be careful, negative 3. What happens to this term right here? A positive times a positive times a negative is negative. 32 times negative 3, negative 96x cubed. Next term, we know the coefficient is 6. When you do 2x squared, don't mess up right here. It's a common mistake. So it's 6 times, you tell me, 4x squared times positive 9. The signs are going to alternate, I will tell you, really quick so we can finish this one. When you multiply that one, you get 216x squared. And this next term, you're going to have 4 times 2x times negative 27. So the sign goes back to being negative again. It's negative 216x. And the last one is 1 times 1 times negative 3 to the 4th. Negative, 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 positive 81. Are you good?